चलो नेक्स्ट आवेज़
यार मेकिंग ऑल दिस थिंग्स
अभ्यानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबद्धन्याय कृष्णप्रेम प्रभाय कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरवत्वे भगवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकाय कृष्णाय कृष्ण मदभक्तायं प्राव्यजन्तमपेतमपेतकृत्यम् वैपायन विरह काल उत्तरे की तन्मयतया प्रभु तम सर्वभूत नमो विष्णु पादाय कृष्ण पृष्ठाय भूते श्रीष्म भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती श्रीवास भानु देवी देवताय कृपा कृष्ण संबंध विज्ञान दायन माधुर ज्योति कृष्ण पान भक्ति श्री गौर करुणा शक्ति विग्रहाय I was speaking there about the special characteristics of the Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur. Also, I began in my evening classes sweet pastimes of Krishna and the teachings. So, I want to tell something, two words about Srila Prabhupada, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur. In so many days, we cannot entirely glorify Srila Prabhupada, endless ocean. So in an hour, or in a day, 2 days, it cannot be explained. Especially this character, in transcendental characteristics, so high that any worldly person cannot touch. As you have seen that in the morning that
Rupanga Bhakti Da. What is Rupanga? Namin Krishna explained a very little. Rupanga, Ragatmi. So he was of the transcendental realm. And the associates of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Radha Krishna. So he has come to give these things. But when he came, there was so much jungle of Mayabad, Sajya, Sakhibad, Sakhi Bheki, Usmatbad, Goswamibad, and first he has to make the barren land
fertile.
To make fertile. So he has to cut all the jungles of all these things. So most of his time went on in this. So when we will glorify him, then we will have to glorify by all these activities. He cut the arguments of all. But after this, when we will touch his glory, transcendental glory, then anyone, very rare person, can touch these things. I know that we are discussing so many things, very sweet pastimes of Krishna, so many good thoughts, Siddhan, but I know that there are someone who has no interest. So they may think that whether I should be in preaching with Narayan Maharaj or I should return to India. It may be. But most of all you are so inspired to hear and wasting a lot of money you are with me, very incongruous, inspired. But when we will explain some extraordinary things, transcendental, or it will be very hard to touch all these things. But general person, general devotees can understand, oh, how he cut Mayava, Smarta, Sahajiya, Sakhi Bheki and all others. How he preached, oh, these things we can understand. But what was the transcendental theories and why he came to this world and what he did for this? Very hard to realize. There are five kinds of these vichar, siddhant, pratyaksha vichar.
Opinion, perception.
No.
Direct perception.
Perception. Five perceptions. Pratyaksha means direct
perception,
which is realized by senses. And we can see, we can touch, we can smell,
we can hear
all these things. Some are aparoksha. We can see, we cannot touch, we cannot, but there is something. And that is called paroksha. Paroksha means English?
Indirect. Hypothesis. Indirect. Hypothesis.
No, on, not on man.
No, hypothesis.
No. Anuman is hypothesis.
So Anuman is not.
Aparoksha, that which is beyond?
Beyond?
Beyond material perception.
That is swara.
Swara.
The happiness and the, which is tested in there, not here. Aparoksha. Then aparoksha. Paroksha, pratyaksha, paroksha, and then aparoksha. What is aparoksha? Not realized by senses. But there is something beyond the limit of this, that is Brahma Tattva. Mukti. Aparoksha is mukti. And then adhoksha. What is adhoksha? Beyond the limit of mind. But not aparoksha, not mukti. Like Narayana Tattva and there the service of Narayana is adhoksha Tattva. अधः कृतम् अतिक्रान्तम् अक्षजम् येन ज्ञानशः च अधोक्षर। These things and the modes which cannot be realized by mind, these are aparoksha. But there is mind of Atma, intelligence of Atma, and everything is there of Atma. So, which is realized in by the senses of Atma, pure, then it is called adhokshaja. So Narayana is adhoksha. And after this aprakrita, when we will serve Krishna in Vrindavan, then with a rush we will realize Vrajendananda Shyam Sundar in four ways. Darsya, Shatka, Varsalya and Madhur. And then Krishna is so beautiful, marvelous. So much opulence, more than Vaikunth, more than Golok, but yet covered with Madhurya. Madhurya means sweetness. So this is called aprakrita. Srila Prabhupada divided in this gyan,
knowledge
in these five categories. And he saw that all the karmis, like those who followed Jaimini by austerities, fire sacrifices, they got sun, so much wealth, reputation and everything. They seek protection. Like Ravana, Jarasandha, Kumbhakarna, Duryodhana, Kansa, they were feeling happiness in worldly all these things. So they are pratyakshatas and they used to sacrifice so much and to attack another to take their kingdom and wealth and wives and so on. So this is called pratyaksha. Then paroksha, the sacrifices for swarga, or so many kings did it. Tetam bhuktasad lokam visalam khine punne matta lokam visanti evam trai dharman prapatna gatagatam kam kamalabhante. By the result of these sacrifices, so many kings, they went to went to swarg and again fell down.
Keeping head down and
what name?
Trishanku.
And so many. Anyone with sacrifice, they will go to swarg again. After testing them, they will have to come to this world. This is paroksha. And Shankar Sampradaya and the followers of Shankara Sampradaya. Aparoksha. Also, we can take, but they are bhakti virodhi, aparadhi. So we cannot count them in this. We can count first stage of Sanat, Sanandan, Sanatan, Sanat Kumar and Sukadeva Goswami in first. They were so much had nishtha in Nirgunya. Nirgunya means no akar, no shape, no attributes, no power. There is something. So this can be aparoksha. And then adhoksha in second stage of Sanakshanandan by the help of
Brahma.
They went to Vaikuntha, taking the very sweet shape, fragrance of Tulsi and Gandha,
sandal,
offered in the lotus feet of Narayana. And they saw Chaturbhuj Murti, very beautiful. And they became servant of, eternal servant of. This is Adhokshar. The associate like Jaya Vijaya and so many Garud, sometimes Narada also, they are serving Adhokshar Narayan. These are of this. Their bhakti is of affluence. Aishwaryamai bhakti. Anything? Name? Aishwaryamai bhakti?
Affluence, full of affluence.
Devotion in awe and reverence.
And after this, we can see bhakti of Rupa Sanatana and Goswamis. The bhakti of gopis. The bhakti of Dandakaranya Rishi, bhakti of the rishas of Vedas, Vedmanga. They became gopi and serving Krishna in Golok Vrindavan. So this is for
aprakita.
Prabhupada has not to create any of the beginning force, not to give pratyaksha, not to give paroksha, not to give adhoksha, Ramanu, Madhva and others, they are given aparoksha,
adhoksha.
But see, Prabhupada has not come to give this. He has come to give this aprakrit mood, bhav. That is Raganga Bhav. By this Raganga Bhav we can enter in the realm of ocean of Ras Braj Bhakti. Especially, not only Braj Bhakti, the mood of Sakhis. How they serve Krishna? And among Sakhi, only mood of Rupa Goswami he has come to be. What is the mood? He is serving conjugal rather than Krishna, but always inclination towards Srimati Radhika. When Radha and Krishna are separated and Krishna comes to his house, Nanda Bhavan, Yashoda Bhavan, and Srimati Radhika returns to Javat or Varshana, then the Sati Rupmanjari, where she will be?
With Srimati Radhika.
Not in Nandagaon. She will come to, she always be present with her Radhika. Always serving. At the time of sleeping, taking prasadam, messaging, giving water, everything, decorating, making bath, everything
like
a shadow, always with Srimati Radhika. She will be happy if Radhika is happy. And if Radhika is unhappy, she will feel unhappy. She will be so happy if Radhika is defeating Krishna. And if Radhika is defeated and Krishna is clapping, then she will be
unhappy,
sadness. So Srila Prabhupada was what manjari?
Nayan manjari.
What is Nayan manjari? The beauty of the eyes of Radhika. What is this beauty? To do archan of Krishna by core of eyes. And Krishna will sit and stand by the indication of these crooked eyes of Sakhis. So he is Nirmal. And he has come only to teach persons this mode. So you can see the glory of Srila Prabhupada. He was in the line of Sarup Damodar, Raya Ramananda, He was in the line of Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, especially Rupa and Raghuna. And sometimes he was following Jiva Goswami, very, very strong in personality and his established Siddhanta. He never compromised with Sahaji Asaki Dekhi Mayabadi. Never. What support? His arguments were so high and strong that anyone coming to Srila Prabhupada used to be bent and fell on the flat on the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada. So, when he was in Puri, I have told that some symptoms of Vaishnava was there. And how he went to Kashim Bazar Naresh and he was teaching his boy like tutor and he returned back from there. And then next Bhaktivinoda Thakur sent him to Mayapur and he took landlordship there only for Prabhupada and he established him there. Then Prabhupada now began Nadip Parikrama that Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written with so many persons. He also preached, they told that, well, who are Brahmin? Those who have the quality of Brahman. Brahminism will not be decided, should not be fixed by work only. There should be some impression, past impression, Shuddha Bhava, Swabhava, nature, the association and the qualities. If Brahmin quality is there, what are the Brahmin? There are 12 qualities of Brahmins. So if, like Sahishnuta, to tolerate, to give anything to others.
Yajan, Jajan, Dan, Udhyan.
So there are so many. So, this should be in Brahmins, especially to Sadhu Krishna. If these qualities are not there, if he is coming in Brahman birth, Brahman dynasty, he is not Brahman. But anyone, anywhere else taken birth. But having the qualities of Brahmins, they are Brahmins. That is why Brahmins were so much angry with Prabhupada. He also told, nowadays, Goswamis, those who have come in the dynasty of Goswami, they are actually Goswamis. Otherwise, anyone cannot be said Goswami. Oh, general person. And this has so much honor for Goswami, Santan, the sons of Goswami. Prabhupada told that this symptom is bad, not authentic. Those who have the quality of Goswami, Govind's Indriya, who can conquer all the
senses.
Like what senses? First sloka of those who have conquered all these things. And they are serving from all senses, Krishna and Radha. Mahaprabhu. They are actually Goswami. Whether they are this, not in the dynasty of Goswami. If a person coming by birth in the dynasty of Goswami, but drinking
wine
and taking flesh, eggs and so many things, and he has a shop of shoes or anything and not having the qualities of Goswami, he is actually not Goswami. Then Goswami became opposite to Srila Prabhupada. Also so many became so much opposite to Prabhupada. But his preaching was going. All the new boys with impressions, they came as brahmacharis and they began to propagate the mission of Srila Prabhupada everywhere, cutting the arguments of Mayavad, Sajyavad, Satyavad and all others and establishing the Siddhanta of Bhakti. So new boys are coming, new girls were coming, women were coming and joining his mission. He gave sannyas to the qualified persons who never fall down. Like my Guru Maharaj, Sridhar Maharaj, Goswami Maharaj, Swami Maharaj,
Madhav Maharaj,
Swami Maharaj is not direct sannyas shishya of Srila Prabhupada. His shishya of sannyasi, shishya of my Gurudev.
Jajavar Maharaj,
last sannyasi.
Vaikhanas Maharaj. Giri Maharaj.
Sauti Maharaj.
Goswami Maharaj.
They were all powerful. They never fell down. They were sadhu. And his brahmacharis, like my Gurudev, and so many Siddha Swarup Brahmachari, he became
Siddhanti Maharaj.
Sridhar Maharaj, his first name was, you remember? Sridhar Maharaj? You don't remember?
Champalabai, did you know?
Sridhar Maharaj. I remember, but I... My remembrance is now so not so. Sridhar Maharaj, he was brahmachari.
Pranavananda.
So many brahmachari.
Hayagri brahmachari.
Sachisunu brahmachari. And some are also of Vanprastha also, like Sauti Maharaj, Goswami Maharaj, and all others. They were. Narahar Parvana Brahmachari. He was Brahmachari. Narsingh Maharaj Brahmachari. So, he made parties, gave diksha, and party made, and sent pitching party everywhere. He opened center, preaching center, not mutt, akhada, wrestling with
arena.
Too many bishops.
Arena.
Not arena. Preaching center. Not so much expensive mutts and mandirs now today here and there. Because after he departed, they will fight for wealth and to be the mahant of that temple. What is going on, like churches. He established preaching centers. Are what you are doing all?
Preaching centers, not big temples.
In any hired room, hired estate, anywhere. Oh, they open center. So that any mamata will not be.
Affection will not be there.
That mine, this is mine. And we will call for this. That is going on new Braja, Vrindavan. New Vrindavan, you know? So much fight and here and there. Not like so. So he established centers. He gave Tridanta Sannyas. That Tridanta Sannyas was stopped after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda. again he established. He saw that Sahajiya Babaji, they are neglecting bhakti rules and now they are mixing so much with ladies and their character is low character. Their bhakti is not Shuddha bhakti. So, brahmacharya, sannyasi and preacher should be very good character. So he made brahmacharya, very pure brahmacharya and sannyasi. And he engaged them in preaching. He established Brihad Mridanga, printing press. And he began to publish the books of Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, others like Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Jeev Goswami, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Narottam Thakur, Gopal Bhatta Goswami, like Satkriya Sadhikika and others books. Srimad Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita. He established so many predicals in Sanskrit. What? Sanskrit, there was. In Bengali, 3-4 magazines in Bengali. Delhi,
Dainik Nadia Prakash.
Delhi, Dainik Nadia Prakash. And then Saptahik Gauriya. And then Pakshik Manish after 14 days, 15 days, in a month, 2 times. Pakshik. And then monthly Gauriya. And Hindi, Bhagavat Patrika, Bhagavat, in English, Harmonist, in Assamia, in Gujarati, in Odia, in Madras, Tamil, Telugu, so all languages of India, he began to theoretical, so many theoreticals. And thus, he began to preach the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And very quickly, he told that you should not go and demand so much heavy
amount
of money. Only 2 paisa, 1 paisa, 1 paisa, you know, a fraction of a hundredth part of a rupee. That is the paisa.
Vincent.
You should collect in boxes. And the key was always with
Prabhupada.
But the box of my Gurudev, Prabhupada gave him because he trusts so much. And they from beginning of the day and up to
evening,
they used to go in where?
Tram, Calcutta tram.
Tram, buses, markets, here or there. They used to tell some Harikatha and then take some 1 paisa, 2 paisa. Always so energetic that never kept any single paisa for them. Paisa to paisa, all used to give to Prabhupada. Nowadays, 75% and 20%. 20% go to head office and 75% in my pocket. And thus go to hell. Sometimes they used to take whole amount. They can show whole amount. Not giving a single farthing to center. And thus going to hell. So at that time, they used to be very bold. Once there was a brahmachari named Siddha Swarup. He went to preach in
East Bengal
with Nemi Maharaj. Oh, Nemi Maharaj, so very learned person, knowing all Shastra, speaking in Sanskrit and pure Bengali. All Darshan Shastra. So he went with him. And when they were preaching, Then Maharaj told Siddhaswarup that you should speak something. And then he began to speak that in Bengal there is a chagal. Chagal, you know?
Goat.
Having so beer. So much beer. And white beer. Always pursuing
goat.
Who is he?
Rabindranath.
He told to Rabindranath Thakur, you own the
Nobel Prize.
To him he told. And he told that there is a gunda of
scoundrel of religion.
Religion. Dakaita and gunda. To whom he told?
Vivekananda.
And he told that he is not Vivekananda, he is Vivekananda. Vivekananda without buddhi.
He has no intelligence.
Without intelligence. And so,
all audience
thousand audience all began to shout. And we don't want to hear, we don't want to hear. They used to praise both. And whole
audience
became so angry. So that meeting was dispersed. Dandani Maharaj wrote a letter, a telegram to Prabhupada. Oh, we were preaching here, very good. But this Siddhaswarup made it ruined. Spoiled our preaching. He told so and so. Prabhupada at once replied in a wire, telegram. Oh, he has preached of lakhs and lakhs, thousands and thousands dollars and money. So high class. He has told true. Tell them that I am coming there to support Siddhaswarup. And a meeting should be called. And I will prove that both were. One was dharmic gunda, religious gunda, and other was chagal. So he went there, Srila Prabhupada, and a big meeting was called, and Prabhupada proved it.
Established too.
And he told that how Rabindranath Thakur like sea goat or he goat. Those who are always pursuing these bhogs. Bhogs means?
Sense enjoyment.
They are chattel like. So he is like that. He had no realization, not speaking about transcendental anything about Krishna, about Gita, Bhagavat and Vedas. And this person, Vivekananda, went to
Chicago
and in a religious discourse he told that Brahmi zero, world is zero, everything is zero. From zero everything has come and from in zero everything will
mix, emerge.
This is dharmic gunda. They don't know every city of
religion.
And he proved it. And then all who were opposite now they came.
Favorable.
And they became Shishya of Gauriya Math. So this was the preaching at that time. Nowadays we can tell, speak true. If you are going to speak true, then in also Gauriya Matha, those who are following are in the Swami Maharaj line. They are also like this, not speaking truth. So nowadays it is very rare Shuddha Bhakti. So Prabhupada was the first person to preach this Shuddha Bhakti, pure Bhakti. He told once in Radha Kunda, when he was in the old age and he wanted to enter in his spiritual transcendental world. 1 or 2 years before, he was in Radha Kunda Parikrama, Braj Mandal Parikrama. He told that, I have come to give transcendental things from Braja and that Rasamai Bhakti. Raganga Bhakti. But my whole life was destroyed in cutting jungle of Mayavas, Sajya, Veki and all others. Don't think that this is our duty only. I am telling for the senior Vaishnava, their solution. If you are going to do, discuss all these things only, and not transcendental bhakti, bhakti, what is bhakti, bhakti, rasa and all these things, what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to give, anarpitcharim chirat karniya vatirunakala, then he will be nirvisheshvadi. No? Try to note all these things. And he told that you should note down all these things. If you are doing only cutting these nonsense argument always, and also you are discussing about Vaidhi Bhakti. He gave a slok that Jnane Prayasa Vadapasan Vanta Eva Jivanta Sanmukharitang Bhavadiya Vata Sthane Sthitatanvan Manubhi. That even you should give up Aishwaryamai Bhakti. Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. You should try to forget. He has six opponents, you should try to forget it. It is for juniors, for Vaidhi Bhakti. Those who want to enter in Vaidhi Bhakti, Rashmi Bhakti. Jnane Prayasam, that Krishna Tattva, Jiva Tattva, Maya Tattva, they should forget all these things. And they should forget that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. Then who is Krishna? He is son of Yashoda. He is son of Nanda Baba. He is friend of Siddham Subal Sakha. And he is beloved of Gopiswami, Deishwandi. And forgot that Krishna. If you will always think like that, Krishna is Supreme Personality of God, having so many opulence, then your bhakti will be so shithil, so weak, feeble. And you cannot enter in Braj Bhakti. Like Yashoda Maiya, he saw the Vishwarupa
universal
form in Krishna mouth two times. But she gave no importance. He thought that any
ghost
has come. Any Maya has come. And she called off all the Brahmins and black cows. Their
cow dung and
urine mix. And with that Krishna was given God. Srimati Yashoda chastised Krishna, banded his
waist
in
Gandhar Mota.
And Krishna was waiting. This is Prajna. Krishna is no Bhagavan, Ishwar, Paramatma, God, nothing. Only the son of Yashoda, beloved of gopis. Very ignorant child of Yashoda. This is the paricha. Paricha means
identification
of Braja Krishna. So if anyone thinking that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead, Swamiji gave this in first
stage.
But he could not give second thing. And he left on me that you should tell, that you should forget that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. No? So these are the thoughts of Srila Prabhupada. That you should note down that you should not do all these things that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead and always go on doing vichar.
Thinking
like this. You should cause all these things. These are dangers of Raganga Bhakti. So I have come to give this, he is telling, in Radhakun. And he became so reddish, his face became. And he was immersed in that mood of Nayan Manjari. So Sri Prabhupada came. So if you will only tell like this, that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead, being senior Vaishnava, so much senior, you should know what is Braja Rasa, Braja Tattva, Bhakti, Raganga, Vaidhi Bhakti, and especially Raganga Bhakti. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to sprinkle the mercy of this Raganga Bhajan. And try to know what is this This is the aim and object of the Gaudiya Math. A diamond is not going, he is now out of Gaudiya Math, he is in Ramanuja, Madhva and other parts. His Narayana is in Gaudiya. So Swamiji has not come for this. I told in a Vyas Puja of Swamiji, Sannyas festival, but anyone could not realize this thing. Oh, he is minimizing Srila Prabhupada. If anyone is telling that, oh, Krishna took Govardhan Hill and his Supreme Personality of Godhead, he can destroy this world. Oh, anyone is so happy. But if you are telling that Krishna, the servant of servant of servant of gopis, oh, you are minimizing Krishna. He will not understand. Oh, Narayana is always minimizing Krishna. And he is making so much supreme to Radhika. I always like to tell these things. So someone tell like this, you are always minimizing Krishna. So they thought that, oh, Narayana Maharaj is minimizing our Gurudev Prabhupada because he preached so much Nam Sankirtan everywhere. I told that this Sankirtan is for common persons. Prabhupada Nam Sankirtan with Bahiranga Layatra Nam Sankirtan. This is the duty of Mahavishnu Advaita Acharya. He cannot give another picture in Chirat. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Group Goswami, they can sprinkle. So your Prabhupada Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj has come to give this, sprinkle this mercy. Not only Kirtan, but through Kirtan he gave this. But nowadays what Kirtan is going on, this Kirtan cannot give that thing. Never in lakhs and lakhs births. Never it can give. Those who are very Uttam Vaishnava or Madhyam Vaishnava of Uttam Vaishnava, they can, by their Kirtan, they can do it. So Nam Sankirtan is supreme, it is true. But if it is done in so high class of Vaishnava, otherwise not, this name will give what? Only worldly things. He can give swarga or moksha. Even say he can give aparoksha, adhokhaya, but not Brajabhakti. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling to Sarupran and Ramarayana, what? Kirupe laile nam prem upajay tahar sarup lakshan kahara suna ramraya trina adapi suni chena tarurupi sahasruna mani na mandina kirtyam yasadah. With a rasik Vaishnava being equipped with four these qualities and with a rasik Vaishnava, finally you will chant Krishna name, then your Krishna name will take you to Braja, otherwise not. So, name is transcendental and so high, but if it is not done in good association, rasik Vaishnava association, only we cannot go to Braja. So these are the teachings of Srila Prabhupada. In his last day, he told that I have made so many persons angry because I have taken their sons, husbands and so many, and I have made them brahmacharis and sannyasi. So they are so much angry. I have cut the argument of karmis, Goswami, smart Brahman, Sahajiya and all others. So all are angry. But I think that soon they will realize that I was not wrong. I have done for the betterment of all the devotees and for the whole world. One day they will realize this fact. So you should do bhajan in the guidance of Ashraya Vigraha. What is Ashraya Vigraha? Srimati Radhika is Abhusarida. Balde Prabhu is Ashtay Vigraha Tattva. And Akhanda Guru Tattva. So in their guidance, in the manifestations of Gurudev, which are qualified Guru, established Guru, Yasur Sad Radha Krishna Kanyugal or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We have this wretched body. We have so many abhav.
Lacking.
Shortcomings. So many. We want so many things. We have so much sufferings. So many pain and painful things. We should not destroy our whole energy to escape from, to save from them. All energy should be given. Where? That what is our main object of the life? Who am I and what is my main object? That main object is to serve Radha Krishna Kanyuga. If a man in the old age, rotten body, if he gives O sarva dharmana pratyajyamami ekam sharanam braja aham tvam sarva papebhyo moksha isyami vacha. He gives his body. Oh Krishna, I offered my
body.
And if he tells like this, Oh Krishna, I am yours. Yes, Krishna is so merciful that he accepts him. And he takes him out of control of Maya and gives bread. So, it may be that so many sufferings and sorrows and all which will come. But we should not try to give energy only to get them out. Never. But what is our object of the life, sadhana, bhajan? And who we are? And how we can have this thing? This is the essence of Chaitanya Srila Prabhupada teachings. He also said, you don't go to please all body. Never.
Everybody.
If anyone going to please everybody, then he cannot please anybody. Only try to please your qualified Guru, Vaishnava and Krishna only, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If I am going to please everybody, that means what means? You have no pure bhakti. We are only, we want what? Only to be a feet dust of Srila Rupa Goswami. This is the highest ambition and desire of any Shuddha Bhakti. No other desire. Nam Sankirtan is supreme but goal of jiva. Param Vijayate, but with devotees, Rashik devotees, Tattvakya devotees, otherwise no. And we should try to follow 8 shloka of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sikshastra. Then everything is there. We should follow Manashikya Upadeshamritam. If you want bhakti, you should read Jaiva Dharma. Very soon we are going to publish it. And then, this is the teachings of Srila Prabhupada. There are so many things. You know how he became the disciple of Srila?
Gorkhasukhdasubhagavan.
Those he was Nitya Siddha, but he saw how a disciple should be and how should accept a guru. Srila Gokushovdasa had told them, don't go to in the realm of Kali, that is Calcutta. And he first established a preaching center there. It says that it is opposite, but not opposite. Who fulfilled the desire of Gokushovdasa Maharaj. From there, he preached our whole Bengal, whole India, and after that, whole world. So, this preaching spirit came from Srila Prabhupada, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And that is why in no time Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj preached all over the world. Now it is our duty to make it stable. What?
To make it
solid.
Solid.
Solid. So that it cannot fly away. And so person will fall down. So they should try to give solid bhakti. Don't have a question, oh, money is, oh, go and bring money. Not this thing. Money will come automatically. I never had any question of money in my anywhere. We don't send any party for
collecting
money. Never. But those who are collecting money, always pursuing money, and you see that all are falling down. We try to preach in the line of Srila Prabhupada, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, in the line of Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, and try to realize his inner mood, not all external things. Those who are external, they will learn only outwardly things, not they will not enter in internal mood. So internal mood was to preach Shuddha Bhakti. Those who are doing Kirtan here and there, I know so many, the priests here and there in France, Germany, Malaysia, Indonesia,
America.
Philippines, America, Canada, all went down, fallen fine, if it is Shuddha Bhakti, is preaching. They collected more than lakhs and lakhs rupees. I know. And Vrindavan, Balraya Krishna temple was built. And in Bombay,
in
Navadvip, lakhs and lakhs dollars, unlimited wealth in India. Who brought where they are now. So we should try to enter in Shuddha, pure bhakti. There are none to speak all truths. If you will speak truth, then oh, so many against person will come. And they are coming. But I am in the line of Luans, like Srila Prabhupada, and I don't fear.
Rigo!
I never worry for my life and it. Because I know that I am eternal.
No,
anyone can touch my this.
No, Atman.
So I am always so bold, like Srila Prabhupada, my Gurudev,
Bhaktivedanta,
like Guru Govind Maharaj. But he was in the last decade, some nervous. But I am not going to be nervous, never. That is why he has so good reputation for me, Guru Govind Maharaj. He told that Narayan Maharaj is a Vaishnava. You can hear Harikatha from him. I am no Vaishnava, I know. I am not so learned person. I have not gone to any school or college. Never. I have been only in school of Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj. Not, I cannot write N-A-R-A-Y. Not. And I wanted to go in the college of Haridas Thakur. But I am not qualified to go. But now they are going to universities, so many big things.
Cambridge
and here and there. What they will learn there? No faith in their gurus that do chant name. And we will have achieved transcendental knowledge and bhakti rasa. So you should not try for these things. These are the lines of teachings of Srila Prabhupada. There are so many teachings, but now it is 7.
Oh, you wanted to tell something about that manga, sir?
Huh?
About
mango,
you
know.
That story is a mango.
He was telling a story about Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Actually, I don't know, but I heard that what he told, it is in a cassette of Swami. What he told. That when he was of 2 years age, and he took any mango, and his father rebuked him, it is not offered to Krishna, and you are taking, and then he stopped for his own life, whole life. But we have seen in any authorized book that any time Prabhupada was, sometime he was in Mayapur, he was very fond of sweet milk cooks. One day, when there was no time of mangoes, and he was in very first place like Mayapur, no connection with anywhere, only on foot any kind, one can go there. And there is no way, always so many thorny ways. So, one day he thought that, oh, if some sweet mango were there, I will offer to Krishna. But he told himself again, oh, it is not good. He rebuked himself. Why you, perhaps your nature is to taste mango, that is why my mind is thinking like so. So he rebuked himself. No? And he slept in the night. In the morning, a parcel from Bombay came of very sweet mangoes. And the servants of Srila Prabhupada, like Paramananda and others, were very happy. And they brought it to Srila Prabhupada. Prabhupada saw this and began to weep. I wished, and Krishna had arranged so sweet mangoes here. I should not take mine in my life. Krishna had to manage whether I should serve myself to Krishna and Krishna is serving me. So I don't want that Krishna should serve me. So he made up his in mind and promised that in my whole life I will not take mango. I will give it to Vaishnavas, I will give it to Thakurji and others. Mood of this story and that story that is same. Only the outer feature is some different. So I tell not in the sense that you are wrong, but in the sense only outer feature. So if Swamiji has written this, not wrong, only he perhaps forgets this thing and he only remembered the stories of mango that he left it for whole life. His mood was only to tell this. So we should try to reconcile all these things. A person like him cannot tell anything wrong, but we should try to reconcile. Sometimes we can say that Krishna has no shape, and in Vedas it has been told, and sometimes it has been told that Krishna has so beautiful shape. There is no mother and father of Krishna. And sometimes it has been told, he is the Jasodanandan. Brahma, Parabrahma, Krishna cannot tell lie. But Krishna sometimes tells lie. So, we should not take one side. We should try to reconcile. In this world, there is no father of Krishna. He is Aja. But in other hand, in bhakti, tattva, Krishna is always eternal son of Yashoda. No fault. So we should try to reconcile all these things. Everything is reconciled in Krishna, but not in worldly things. So there are so many things. Now we can come in Krishna pastimes. A kirtan should be done.
One thing, he said that he's heard Srila Gaura Govinda Maharaj give both examples.
He told? Yes, very good. A kirtan? You should do.
Goranga boli te habe Kulaka sharira Hari Hari
Vajo
Yani Mabe Nira
Kulaka boli te habe Kulaka sharira
Thank you.
Just follow me and come to Braj Gokul. Jashoda Maiya has caught Krishna and he is chastising. Oh, friend of monkeys, liar, and thief, I will punish you. Then Krishna began to weep bitterly. Mother, mother, don't beat me. And in the meantime, so many neighborhood, old women came and they also told Yashoda, all this Shakti you have received in
middle age.
In middle age, you are going to be old. And so, sweet boy, soft boy, and you are going to beat him, don't do so. So when Krishna is beating, like, bring, so like children's,
so big,
talking so much. His whole body was
shaking.
Huh? And with one hand, Yashoda has caught his from right hand, left hand. So with the right hand or left hand, he is doing like this. Mother told me to. Then Yashoda told, I will beat him, but I will bind you in that
mortal
who helped you in butter thieving.
Accomplice. The child.
Helper.
A friend.
So, both are guilty. Those who inspired and helped, and those did the action, both are liable to be punished. So, you and on which you are standing and giving butters to others, both should be punished. So, I will bind you in that
mortar grinder.
Then he took his very resham vastra,
silken
robe, reddish, to whom, by whom he has tightened his
braid.
He opened and he began to bind. First he wanted to bind Krishna waist. This was about 3 feet or more than that. And Krishna's waist was only 12 fingers. And also it was binded by golden chain with
twinkling bells.
Looking very beautiful. And he wanted to do it. But it was not enough to bite at one time also. It became less by 2 fingers. Then he told to his sakhis, O sakhi, you should bring ropes from my house. Said, they were so much curious. They told that, mother, you cannot do, Sakhi, you cannot bind Krishna. Brahma has not written any binding in Krishna. So you should be stopped. But he told, I will see. And they brought so many ropes, very, very long, long, and all were together, joined. And again she wanted to make one round, but even there was not completed one round. Again 2 fingers, not 3 or 4, not one, only 2 fingers. Again she brought another. And thus whole ropes of Yashoda were brought and they were joined together, but it was not enough to make one round even. Always 2 fingers. Then he told, oh Sakhis, bring from your houses. And in a curiosity, all these Sakhis went to their houses and brought so much. And all were tightened together. But even, it is wonderful that the ropes were
longer together.
Went and it became long and long. And Krishna's waist was only 12 fingers. Not going taller or bigger, but only 2 fingers. All times. Why? There is a reason. Yashoda's face became reddish, sometimes yellowish. That I cannot bind my child who came from my own, but I will continue for her whole age. I will not take any water or anything. Day and night I will try to bind him. And other sakis were clapping. Oh, Krishna, you cannot bind Krishna. Why it became? Krishna is endless powerful, Sarvashaktiman. All kinds of power are invested in Krishna. Krishna, in among there is a Vishin Shakti. Vishin means?
Desire.
He thought that if my mother is bind me, that I cannot play with boys who are waiting for me. Who? Dam Shidam, Sudam Padmangal and all. And the cows are waiting for me. They will not give milk to their own calves. When I will go, then seeing me they will give up any milk. So they are hankering for me. And I cannot play with boys. So this wish is himself one with Krishna. So at once Ichha Shakti came, Sarva Shakti came. The vest was only 12 finger and rope became so longer and longer and longer, but still 2 fingers. Because Krishna wanted that mother should not
bind me.
So we can practice anything to help darshan of Krishna. By sadhana we cannot do anything. And Krishna is merciful if you are not doing any sadhana. And Krishna says, even you cannot bind. So there are 2 things. Those who are actually devotees, sadhak, always doing sadhana, like Yashoda, always bending. And seeing this, Krishna is so merciful. When he saw, the sweats are coming like pearls. And Yashoda is now restless. And his mouth, face is going somehow changing. So she is now restless. And seeing this, the sweats of Yashoda, Krishna became merciful. Krishna is in Sarva Shakti, there is a Vatsalya Bhav, meaning mercy of Krishna. This Kripa Shakti, the Shakti of mercy, is highest. When Krishna became so happy and his heart was melted, at once Kripa Shakti came. And at once opulence
disappeared.
Of Sarva Shakti. At once disappeared. So, the practice of bhakta, labor of bhakta, sadhana, the labor in sadhana.
Endeavor.
In sadhana. And Krishna mercy both. When they will be together, then anyone can control Krishna. Otherwise, no. These are of 2 kinds, Markat and Marjatnaya. What is Markatnaya and Marjatnaya? Markat means monkey. Monkey theory. Monkey logic and kitten. Never do anything, only cry. Meow, 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 meow And mother comes and catches hold from his mouth, her mouth, and takes any way, any place she wants. But monkeys are of different type, opposite type. If monkeys are running or jumping, they will stay for a moment. And their boys, monkey, baby monkey will come. And also at once jump on his, anywhere here, or on the back, or in the stomach. And they will catch hold with
four hands.
Like, you know. And mother will jump so much here, run them, but they will be. They will not be fall down. And if in case fall down,
they never touch.
He never takes like his son. Or he gives up forever. And the baby boy dies. So we should not follow both. We should not be like monkey. That by effort we can, by our sadhana we can have the Krishna prem or Krishna. But without mercy we cannot do anything. And if you depend on only mercy, not doing nothing like kitten, then you will have to have a zero money. So both should be there. Our sadhana and Krishna bhakti both will make us to control Krishna. Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave an instruction at Imjambu. A man has fallen down in a well. And the well is so deep, full of water, deep water, in a jungle. He began to cry, "Save me, save me." A very kind person came. And he saw that a person is fallen down in the well. So he gave a rope that you should catch hold of this
rope
and I will pull you up. But he was not
ready to catch that rope.
So the person saw that he is not coming, not taking,
holding.
So he went off. And he was there. He has given the rope. This is the mercy of Krishna. And we should try to hold that mercy. To hold Gurudev, to Vaishnava associates. These are ropes. And we should hold, we should attend this thing. And then by this both we can go. So the two fingers are what? One Krishna, mercy, and other is our
endeavor.
So both, when they will meet, that Krishna will be good. So, when Krishna saw that my mother is so much worried for binding me, and sweets are coming, and he prayed to his Salagram that be merciful. How I can show my face to my friends if I am not minding her? So Krishna knew this and became merciful. And at once, only by that rage,
silken rope,
he was binded. And then she binded in Okal also. Okal means granted mortal, and Krishna also. How she binded? Krishna was like standing here, and rope was given, and here one knot, and then to
grinded motor,
so that Krishna hand cannot go.
Reach there.
Roach is there, so Krishna cannot
open
the untie the rope. And thus he told the boy that you should look after, I am going to
and
to do other things here. And they were began to look after. Krishna was sleeping up till now, but when Yasoda, why she did? Because if I will not bind, he will go out of house. He is very naughty. He may fall down on Jamuna and he may run towards forest like monkeys. Then what I will do? So he thought that if I am binding her and after my this job, I will come and pacify that boy, and then he will very calm and quiet. I will give him my bill and then he will be satisfied. Then I will untie. So thinking this guy. But what became? I will tell
tomorrow.
Go. Krishnadas, come on.
Aha!